In order to keep our gut healthy, that means that we want to make sure that our digestive tract is working to its optimal level. Keeping your gut healthy, you can prevent diverticular disease, you can prevent colon cancer, and then you can just prevent the everyday gas or distension, not having regular bowel movements. These are all things that by following our 5 key steps, you can make sure that you have good gut health. Number one is chew, chew, chew. Chewing actually starts the digestive process by breaking down the food, and it helps our body to secrete gastric enzymes. So while we chew our food to an applesauce consistency, it actually gives our GI tract less work to do. So by chewing well, we don't have to work as hard at digesting our food. Also, when we don't chew well, we tend to swallow more air, and that can lead to gas or distension and pressure in our abdomen. Number two is aim for 25 to 35 grams of fiber per day. Fiber is really important because it helps to increase our fecal weight, and it helps to decrease the time that our food sits in our colon. And by doing that, it decreases our risk of colon cancer, it decreases our risk of diverticular disease, and it helps us to have healthy, regular bowel movements by decreasing constipation. It's very important to add whole grains to our diets. We want to focus on things that are 100% whole wheat, bread that has at least 3 grams of fiber per slice, and we also want to look outside of the box to introduce foods like quinoa or other grains to our diet to increase our fiber intakes. Number three is to focus on whole foods when we're trying to increase our fiber. Today, food manufacturers have added isolated fibers to all sorts of food products. So it's easy to think that by eating 5 ice cream sandwiches a day, we're meeting our fiber needs. However, research doesn't support that. Research has shown that getting the fiber from whole foods is more beneficial than the isolated fibers that are added to foods. When you're increasing fiber, it's important to do so slowly. So just adding 2 to 5 grams per day while making sure that you have adequate fluids should do the trick. Number four is to increase your fluids. It's very important when you're increasing your fiber to also increase fluids so that you prevent constipation. Besides this, both diarrhea and constipation can actually be a sign that you're dehydrated. Number five is not to over-restrict your diet. When we have some uncomfortable GI symptoms, to blame a specific food or food category. People think that if they never have lettuce again, or that if they avoid dairy products altogether, then they won't have the diarrhea, they won't have the gas and the discomfort that they've had in the past. Oftentimes, this is not the case. Even people who are lactose intolerant can many times tolerate eating yogurt or some hard cheeses. Keeping your gut healthy, it'll help to decrease digestive diseases later on in life, and it also helps to reduce pain or discomfort that you might have in your normal day life.